Hi everyone, and welcome to my YouTube channel. So I'm just out this morning over at West Mersey, trying to get some of the sunrise today. So hopefully the cloud looks a little bit broken on the horizon. So getting a couple of little bit of sort of pink of the early morning rays on the clouds as well. So hopefully working out to be a good day. Okay, so I've just got a composition set up here, looking obviously along the line of the beach huts here, which are fantastic, all different colours, and hopefully I'll be able to bring that out within the images as I obviously as the sun gets brighter, as it obviously rises up, I can obviously get more of the detail, more of the colours in the beach huts, but obviously leading along the line to where obviously the sun is actually rising as well. Apologies for the wind noise if you're picking that up on the microphone. Obviously we are on the coast, so it's a bit difficult here this morning. But I really knew that obviously the sun was rising in this direction. I've done a bit of pre-planning as well and looked on the photographer's ephemeris website and obviously made sure that the alignment of where the sun was rising today was going to be bang in line with the sort of ends of the huts. So the idea of the compositions is obviously having the beach huts leading you along the left-hand side of the image and obviously then the sun rising in the sort of centre of the image, and then obviously trying to get two-thirds of the image full up of the sky with obviously all of the colour and the details in here as well. So I got here just before 6 o'clock in the morning. Sunrise is about 6:40, so hopefully just taking several more images. So the image I've got set up here is F11 ISO 100, and what I'm doing is an exposure stack. So I'm exposing for the beach huts, taking one image, which is about sort of 10 seconds, and then obviously doing a second image for the sky, which is about 5 seconds, and then obviously blending those two together in post-processing. So working out really well. So I just moved down the beach a little bit now and come across some of this grass that I've been able to sort of put down in the bottom section of the image as well, and obviously keeping that balance there as well, giving a bit of interest in the foreground as well. And obviously again in having the beach huts leading on the left hand side of the image, obviously to the rising sun in obviously the centre of the image, and again obviously keeping two-thirds of the image of the sky. So again with this one, I've kept the settings at F11 ISO 100. And focus on the grass in the foreground, then switched over to the exposure box, taking an exposure or taking one image with the obviously grass as the exposure, then obviously re-exposed for the sky, and then again obviously blend those two together in post-processing. So working out to be a really good morning so far. So, like all good plans with photography, it's always scuppered by the weather. Unfortunately, there's the cloud on the horizon is obviously increased a bit now, and actually has obviously completely cut out the rising sun. The sun is due to rise about sort of 3 minutes ago. So it's obviously cut out all those details. However, there is still a few breaks, so one can only hope that obviously the conditions are going to improve. So what I've done now though is I've come down to one of these sort of sandbanks here to obviously get a different view, looking back across to obviously the beach huts, and trying to then pull out any detail that I can of the colours of the rising sun in the obviously cloud detail. So again, for this one, f11 ISO 100, and exposing for the foreground, and then taking another exposure for the sky as well, and again obviously blending the two together. Don't be defeated is the key that I'm trying to say to myself time and time again. So unfortunately the colour's not really coming out as yet, still going to persevere with it though. There's a very tiny little sort of break in the cloud just above the sort of horizon line, but it's not really sort of casting any light in this direction, unfortunately. It's the sun sort of moving around in the opposite direction. Also, to rub a bit of salt into my wounds as well, is it's started to sort of spit with rain as well. So hopefully it won't mount to too much, but just have to stick it out and see. And you probably know if I end up back in the car and doing a final piece of camera, you know that it ends up being too wet. So I've just recomposed for the next one, obviously still on the little sandbank here, but trying to obviously get the full sort of bend of the actual water inlet here as it's coming in, as the tide's on its way in as well, trying to obviously create that sort of sweeping line through the actual image as well, leading up to the beach hut, and obviously then trying to pick out some of the detail as well in the sky. Again, obviously taking the exposure for the sort of beach huts in the foreground, and then obviously another exposure for the sky as well, and again blending it together. Again, settings for that, F11, ISO 100, and aperture priority mode as normal. So I think the sun's now been up for about sort of 20 minutes, 25 minutes maybe, and the colour is not really looking like it's going to come back. The clouds look like they're actually increasing rather than decreasing, which is always the way, isn't it? You always sort of look, and when you haven't got your camera to hand, it's always perfect conditions, and when you have, it obviously never works out, does it? But few words for that, I think, but won't say that on here. But I think I'm gonna probably call it a day now, go and get some breakfast, as obviously tummy rumbling. But thanks a lot for watching. Make sure you give it a thumbs up if you've liked the video today. Please also make sure you comment as well, so I do respond to every comment that's made about my videos. And if you've enjoyed it as well, please make sure you subscribe as well. Thanks a lot for watching, and take care.